गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस लेसन टू चिल्ड्रेन एट वर्क फ्रॉम योर बुक इट सो हैपेंड दिस इज योर सप्लीमेंट्री रीडर। यू नो देयर आर मेनी रीजंस व्हाई चिल्ड्रेन हैव टू वर्क। Some help their family make a livelihood, who run away from unhappy homes need to support themselves. Children who have to work cannot go to school and play like other children of their age. This is the tragedy of poor countries where children earn money for support of their life or support of to their families. Some of them work in dhabas, they wash plates and cups in hotels, they graze cows, but remember this is the age for their study and play. It can be bad luck to children who work for livelihood. Dear children, in this context, we are going to study this lesson, Children at Work. There is a child, his name is Velu. An 11-year-old boy runs away from home. He wanders around for hours before getting on a train to Chennai without a ticket. Tired and hungry, he does not know where to go when a stranger at the station shouts a word of welcome. Now we will discuss these three points. When the Kanyakumari Express pulled in, means arrived at Chennai Central, this is the name of the station, railway station, remember, pulled in, arrived at Chennai Central. It took Velu some time to get off because he was unknown there. When he finally stood on the platform, his legs felt wobbly as if he was still on a moving train. Wobbly means unsteady, means not steady. His legs felt wobbly means unsteady as if he was still on a moving train. Oh, out of the way, a porter, that is a coolie, went by with a loaded trolley. Velu jumped aside to give him way, to give the porter or give the coolie the way. He sat on a bench. Who sat on the bench? Velu sat on the bench on the platform, pulling his small bundle down. In all his 11 years, he had never seen so many people except once a year at the fair in his village. People walked by, bumping into him with their suitcases. A voice announced something on a loudspeaker. Perhaps you have heard the voice when you were there on a platform. Near him, a group of people sat on their luggage, looking at a TV hanging from the roof. The noise was terrible. The noise was awful. Velu put his head down on his knees, feeling miserable, feeling very sad and exhausted, tired. He had run away from his village 2 days ago. For 2 days, he had eaten nothing but some peanuts and a piece of जैगरी, जिसको हम लोग खांड कहते हैं, जैगरी गुड़. इन हिज बंडल ही कैरियड ए शर्ट, ए टॉवल एंड ए कॉम्प. ही हैड वॉक्ड फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ द फर्स्ट डे टू कनूर एंड देन गॉट ऑन द ट्रेन टू चेन्नई. वेलू हैड नो मनी फॉर ए टिकट, but luckily the ticket collector did not come to the unreserved compartment. There are different kinds of compartments in a train. Some are reserved compartments and one or two compartments are there which are unreserved. He had tried to sleep on the floor near the door. A group of men next to him had played cards and shouted all night. That is why he could not sleep on the floor. Hey, what new to town, eh? Called out a rough voice, a harsh voice. You see, there is a girl. Velu is sitting on the bench, you can see in the picture. And this girl told him, "Hey, what? New to town, eh?" called out a rough voice. Velu opened his eyes. There were a lot of people standing around, but nobody was looking at him. "Here, eh?" He turned around. Behind him was a girl around his own age, wearing a long banyan that came down to her knees. Her hair was stiff and brownish, and she had a huge sack. You can see on her back. Huge means big, big sack. You can see the sack on the back of the girl on one shoulder. She was picking up dirty plastic cups from the floor and stuffing them, means filling them. Into her sack. "Why is she calling me, though, Velu?" thought Velu. "And why is a girl wearing a banyan?" She had never seen a girl wearing a banyan in his village. So he was surprised. Velu was surprised. "No need to stare stupidly." Stupidly means foolishly. No need to stare. Stupidly, foolishly. "What is your name?" Velu muttered. Velu said in low voice. Velu said in a low voice. "Velu, looking away. So Mr. Velu, said the girl, looking at his bundle, run away from home. The girl is asking Velu, run away from home? Velu did not answer. He did not want to tell some strange girl what he had done. He had run away because he could not stand his father beating him for one more day. His father would snatch away, means took forcefully. Snatch means took forcibly away all the money Velu and his sisters earned and spent it on drink. This was the story of Velu. Velu and his sisters earned money while they were children, but all the money was snatched by their father. Don't think I don't know. This place is full of children like you, the girl is telling to Velu. So what are you going to do here? Become rich? The girl is asking to Velu. She sat down next to him. Velu shifted away slightly. He felt hunger. Means Velu felt hunger pinching him. And pressed his stomach with a grimace. Grimace is twisted expression on the face due to pain. Hungry? Asked the girl. You would not get food by sitting here gloomily, sadly, making faces. I can find some if you want. Means I can find some food for you if you want, the girl tells. She picked up her sack and started to walk away. Velu stayed on the bench. What should he do? Should he follow this girl? Where was she going to take him? She was disappearing into the crowd. So he had to make up his mind quickly. All right, he decided. Anyway, I have no idea where to go. He jumped up and ran after her. She was not even looking back to see where he was. Dear children, there are some questions. These questions are very helpful for you to know you have understood this part of lesson or not. Now, question number one. Velu stood on the platform, but he felt as if he was still on a moving train. Why? You know. Velu stood on the platform as if he was still on the moving train because, very important for you, he had traveled in a standing position in the train. Yes? Question number two. What made him feel miserable? Tiredness. Just you have read, tiredness and nervousness made him feel miserable. Question number three, part one. Velu traveled without a ticket. Why? You can easily answer this question. Velu traveled without a ticket because he had no money to buy a ticket because he was poor. Second part of question number three. How did he escape the ticket collector's attention? Yes. you know. He escaped the ticket collector's attention because the ticket collector did not come to examine the ticket in his compartment. What kind of his compartment was? Unreserved compartment. Just you have seen question 4. Why had Velu run away from home? Velu had run away from home because his father used to beat him and snatch his earnings. Okay. Question number 5. Why did he decide to follow the strange girl? Yes. He decided to follow the strange girl because he had no hope in Chennai except that girl. Now, part 2. Velu followed his friend through the crowded streets to a big building. Behind the building, there is a big garbage bin. Velu wonders why they are there at all. Now, the explanation of these 3 points. He caught up with the girl as she was leaving the station. When they got to the road, Velu found that the vehicles kept coming and never stopped for anyone. Smoke and dust flew at him from all sides, making his head spin. Means giving him a headache or making him feel dizzy or giddy. They had to wait for a long time before they could find a gap to run through. Velu kept hesitating and the girl finally dragged him to the other side of the road. What do you think you are doing? Grazing cows? If you stand around in the middle of the road like that, you will be chutney. Do you know chutney? Sauce. Well, his heart was still beating fast. He looked back at Central station and the traffic speeding by. How had they managed to come through that? They walked along the side of the road under some huge signboards. Velu looked up at the pictures, banyans, car tires, pain, a woman holding a box. The writing was all in English, so he did not know what it meant. The girl turned on to a wide breeze and walked up. Velu stopped and peeped over. Peeped over means looked through the railing. Under him, the road ran into the city. In the distance, he could see huge buildings and towers and more roads. See that big building with the wall around it. If you are not careful, you will soon be counting bars there. The girl grinned and pointed at a huge building. Velu squinted and read the Tamil sign. It was written Central Jail. Why? I have not done anything wrong, Velu said. The girl is telling. You don't have to do anything, just don't get caught. That is all. What does she mean? Velu wondered. Meanwhile, the girl was already heading down the bridge with the sack on her shoulder. What was in it? Velu was thinking. He had seen her putting plastic cups into it at the station. What are you carrying in that bag? The girl is answering. Things, bottles, paper. Velu wondered what she was doing with them, but he felt shy to ask any more questions. It was still morning, but the sun blasted down on the tar and Velu's bare feet burned. Velu had no shoes or chappal in his feet, so Velu's bare feet burned. It was not like walking on a mud road. Kachi sadak. He was habitual to walk on mud road. He was soaked with sweat. He tried hard to walk in the shade and keep up with the girl at the same time. She walked really fast. How far away was the food? After almost an hour of walking, they stopped in front of a big building. Sri Raj Rajeshwari Prasanna Kalyan Mandapam, it was written on the big building. Read Velu slowly. A shine with letters made of flowers said, Groom J.V. Vinayagan, Bride Rani. Velu stared at the big cars parked outside. This was a marriage place, or you say marriage hall, you can say. One of the cars had a flower garland and roses taped onto it. The girl looked around. One of quickly and stuck it in her hair. Come on, she said. Are we going to eat here? Asked Velu. Looking at the huge hall and the people inside, Hopes, said the girl, shaking her thumb under his nose. She led him behind the hall. There was a big garbage bin. Garbage is a rubbish bin, overflowing with rubbish. Two goats were standing on the pile, fighting for a banana leaf. A cloud of flies buzzed around their legs. There was a rotten smell in the air. The girl picked up a squashy banana, crushed banana, and held it out to Velu. Here is your food. Velu was shocked. Are we going to eat their leftovers? Unka jhuthan khaye. Leftovers. Chhi. What do you think I am? A dog? I only take untouched food. Here, some more. Catch. She threw him a vada. Velu looked at it with distaste, means without taste. कमॉन हीरो ईट इट, यू थिंक आई लाइक इट, आई टोल्ड यू आई विल फाइंड यू समथिंग टू इट, डोंट थिंक आई हैव मनी टू बाय फूड फॉर यू, यू'ड बेटर इट वाट यू गेट अंटिल यू हैव योर ओन मनी. वेल यू हेजिटेटेड, बट हिज स्टोमक स्क्वीज्ड हिम. स्क्वीज्ड मीन्स ही वॉज वेरी हंग्री. हिज स्टोमक व्हिच वॉज एम्प्टी ट्विस्ट एंड पेंट. ही गल्प्ड डाउन द बनाना एंड वड़ा. हिज स्टोमक फेल्ट बेटर इमीडिएटली. ही कुड हैव ईटन एट लीस्ट 10 times more, but the girl could find only one more banana, which she ate herself. It is too early. They have only eaten tiffin. If you are still hungry, you will have to wait for them to finish lunch. You can wait. If you want, I have to work. I am going. She picked up a couple of bottles from the heap and threw it into her sack. Then she walked off. Velu panicked. Panicked means was very worried, was very nervous. He realized that if the girl left him, he had no idea where he was and what to do. It was better to stick to her. She seemed to know her way around. He ran after her again and he called. He did not even know the girl's name. "Hey, what is your name?" he asked, hurrying behind her. She stopped and turned around. "Oh, so you have been following me around without even knowing my name?" The girl told her name to Velu. "Jaya, I am not following you." "What then? Who got you food? Can I come with you? Where are you going? Come if you want. This bag is full. I have to go home to get another one." Means another one means another bag. Dear children, there are 4 questions for comprehension check. You can see. First, can Velu read Tamil and English? How do you know? Velu could read only Tamil because he read Central Jail, which was written in Tamil. Okay? But he could not read the signboards which were written in English. Okay? Question number 2, part 1. If you are not careful, you will soon be counting bars there, the girl said. What is she referring to? Can you tell? She is referring to the Central Jail. Part 2. What does she mean when she says, if you are not careful? She says something a little later, which means the same. Find that sentence. She means that if he is not careful, he can be caught by the police because he is unknown in Chennai. The line in the text is, "You don't have to do anything, just don't get caught." दैट इज ऑल. ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 पार्ट 1. Where did the girl lead Velu to? The girl led Velu to the backyard of Sri Raj Rajeshwari Prasanna Kalyan Mandapam. Part 2, question 3. What did they get to it? They got a crushed banana and a vada. Question 4. What work did she do? Think of a one word answer, that is rag picking. Remember this, rag picking. Part 3. There is a row of huts near some dirty puddles. Outside one of the huts, Jaya dumps her sack, grateful to his friend Velu, thinks of the days ahead. Jaya and Velu walked along the roads for half an hour until they came to a bridge across a dirty trickle of water. We are in triplicane now. See, that is Buckingham Canal, said Jaya. Do you know what is Buckingham Canal? This is very famous canal of the world. Buckingham Canal. Velu stared. This was a canal. Near some puddles of water was a row of the strangest huts he had ever seen. They were built out of all sorts of things: metal sheets, tires, bricks, wood, and plastic. Perhaps you have seen such kind of the house in your city. They stood crookedly. Crookedly means not straight, and looked as if they would fall any moment. In this, where you live, these houses are strange, said Velu. In our village, the houses are made of mud and palm leaves. Jaya went around to one of the huts and dumped her sack outside. Then she picked up an empty one. Let us go. She turned to Velu and gave him a shove. Shove is push. She gave him a push. At least help me now. Here, wear these and come with me. What did she give Velu? She threw him a pair of old shoes without laces and pushed a sack and a stick into his hand. Velu was confused. What work did she want him to do with these things? The only work he had ever done was on the landowner's farm, weeding. Weeding is working in a field, removing grass or digging, and taking cows out to graze. Are there any farms in the city? He asked Jaya. She laughed and thumped her stick on the ground. Farms? There are no farmers here. We are rag pickers. Rag pickers? See my sack full of things I collected. Collected? From where? Asked Velu. From rubbish bins. Where else? You collect rubbish? Velu had never heard of such a thing. A blockhead. Blockhead means fool. F-O-O-L. It is not any rubbish, only paper, plastic, glass, such things. We sell it to Jam Bazaar, to Jaggu. Velu was puzzled. He had heard of people throwing away rubbish. But why would anyone want to buy rubbish? Who is Jam Bazaar Jaggu? Why is he buying all this? The girl says, you think he buys it for so? He sells it to a factory. Come on, I don't have time to waste like you. Velu did not move. He had not run away and come to this new place to dig through garbage bins. Jaya poked him. Jaya pushed him sharply at him with her stick. Look here, she shouted. If someone gets there before us, we don't get anything. Don't just stand there posing. Posing means looking important, hoping to impress others. Big hero, I am trying to help you, who filled your stomach today. Velu scratched his head and sighed. I will do it for now, he thought, until I find a better job. Dear children, there are two or three questions for comprehension. See them. Question 1, part 1. What material are the strange huts made out of? The strange huts are made of metal sheets, tires, bricks, wood and plastic. Okay? Part 2 of question number 1. Why does Velu find them strange? Velu finds them strange because in his village, the houses are made of mud and palm leaves. Okay. Question 2. What sort of things did Jaya and children like her collect, and what did they do with those things? Jaya and children like her to collect paper, plastic, glass and such other things. They used to sell them to Jam Bazaar, to Jaggu. Question number 3. Is Velu happy or unhappy to find work? Give a reason for your answer. Velu is not happy, very happy to find work, because he had come to the city for other work. So he tells, I will do it for now until I find a better job. Dear children, read this lesson again and again so that you may understand this lesson very well. If you have any kind of problem, you listen this video again and again. Okay, try to answer the questions which have been discussed.
by yourself. Write the answers of these questions immediately. Thank you.